Hello everybody, our subject name is Machine Learning and Application. Myself, Professor Pankaj Shukla, IT Department. So our today's topic is subset selection. Outline and content, attribute selection, various approaches, example, and finally the conclusion. So what are the importance of attribute selection? That is subset selection, or it also called as a feature selection. Okay. So this is all the same terminology like feature selection, attribute selection and subset selection. So what are the important of this attribute selection? So it reduces the cost of learning by reducing the number of attributes, and it provides the better learning performance compared to full attribute set. Consider there is a full attribute set is given, but we have to select some of the important features from that. So there is a learning performance is very much better, and also it is increases, and it also reduces the cost by learning all the attribute set than the selecting proper attribute set. Okay, so mainly to reduce the cost and also provide the better learning. So, dimensionality reduction by feature selection in machine learning. How to reduce the feature selection and how to select a feature so it may affect the dimensionality reduction. So, reason for dimensionality reduction, as already we know that in our previous video we see that why actually the reason for the dimensionality reduction, to improve the prediction performance. We have to improve the learning efficiency. Also, there is a provide faster prediction from the possibly requesting less information, and also to reduce the complexity of the learned result. So these are the reasons to reduce the dimensionality reduction. So these are the various approaches for the dimensionality reduction. So first one, we have to map the original feature onto the reduced dimensionality space. Okay, so selecting a subset of the original feature. So there is a sum of the feature is given, and from that we have to select the subset. No feature transformation, just to select the feature subset. Only the subset is selected. Then constructing the feature to replace the original feature. So by using some statics such as a PCA, we will see in the next video what is actually PCA. By using that, we have to construct the feature, and we have to replace that original feature. Then next one, using the background knowledge for constructing a new feature. Suppose consider some of the general background knowledge is given for you, and by using that some domain specific background knowledge is given to you, and by using that background knowledge we have to construct new feature which is addition or instead of the original feature. Okay. So general background knowledge like sum or product of the feature, like noun phrases, clustering of the word, different types of user specific functions. So these are the various types of approaches to reduce the dimensionality reduction by using some of the subset selection, construct the feature and background knowledge for the constructing of the new feature. Consider the example. Suppose there is a data set is given, F1, F2, F3, F4 and F5. So F1 data is given, here F1 all the data is given, then F2 data is given, F3 data is given. Okay, so there is a 5 boolean feature is given. These all the data sets and having the different types of feature, F1, F2, F3, F4, F5. So we find some of the C, that is feature of the C, from the F1 and F2. Okay. And we also take the optimal subset from F1 and F2 and F1 and F3. So optimization in a space of all feature subset possibility is given. So search for feature subset. Okay, so example of search which is given by John and Kobe in 1997. So we have to select by using the forward selection, and we have to eliminate from the backward elimination. So this is the actual feature subset. This will create this pattern. So how to feature subset? So commonly search strategies kya hoti hai? Forward selection. So hum kya karenge? Greedily added a feature one at a time. So we have to add way of subset into that. Forward stepwise selection. We have to add and remove feature one at a time. Okay. हम ऐड भी कर सकते हैं, रिमूव भी कर सकते हैं वन एट अ टाइम. देन बैकवर्ड एलिमिनेशन, ग्रीडिली रिमूव फीचर वन एट अ टाइम. एंड बैकवर्ड स्टेप वाइज एलिमिनेशन, ऐड और रिमूव फीचर एट वन एट अ टाइम. एंड फाइनल इज द रैंडम म्यूटेशन, दैट मीन्स वी ऐड एंड रिमूव रैंडमली सिलेक्टेड फीचर वन एट अ टाइम और स्टॉप इवन गिवन नंबर ऑफ इटरेशन. सो दीज आर द कॉमनली यूज स्ट्रैटेजीज, फॉरवर्ड सिलेक्शन, फॉरवर्ड स्टेप वाइज सिलेक्शन, बैकवर्ड एलिमिनेशन, बैकवर्ड स्टेप वाइज एलिमिनेशन, in random mutation. The next one is the approaches for the feature subset selection. The first approach is a filter evaluation function independent of the learning algorithm. Next one is the bracket evaluating using the model selection, which is based on a machine learning algorithm. Embedded approach like feature selection during that learning. Simple filter, suppose assume feature independence, use for the problems with a large number of features, like a test classification. So these are the various types of approaches, like one is filter, wrapper, embedded approach. So in filter, suppose there is an independent model is given, learning algorithm is independent. In wrapper, some of the evaluation is by using some of the selection is based on some of the machine learning algorithm. In embedded approach, there is a learning method is there, and during learning some of the feature is selected. And finally is the filter, which is simple filter, which is does not depend upon the feature independent. Okay. So these are the various approaches for the feature subset selection. So mainly two approaches, filter approach and wrapper approach, which is generally used. So in the filter approach, it attempt to access the merit of attribute from the data and in the learning algorithm. So it not focuses on some of the algorithm, it only focus on the attribute from the data. But in the wrapper approach, the attribute subset selection using the learning algorithm is a black box. Okay. So in the wrapper and filter approach is very much different. In filter approach, they totally ignore the learning algorithm and select the attribute from the data. In wrapper approach, it done biasing the learning algorithm. So most simple filter approach is ranking of attribute according to the chi-square of two tables, the confusion matrix is there. So this is the confusion matrix. So actual class is here. Here suppose consider D and B J is there, and D and B J is there. Okay. So it is the predict test class. Here true positive rate, false positive rate, false negative rate and true negative rate. So this is the confusion matrix. It actually creates some of the confusion. Okay. So chi square of two tables, and suppose x square is finding value. So observe count is 9 minus expected count. And finally there is expected value. How to take a summation on that and expected count in any cell in the two table. How to calculate the expected count? Row total. How many total values? Suppose consider 15 total values. How many column values? Suppose 20 column values. And total count is suppose 15 plus 20, that is 35 count value is there. So in that way the expected count is calculated. And from that expected count, suppose from the 30, only the 20 is observed count. So observed count is. So large value x square is better attribute. If the value of x square is large, it means use the better attributes. So please go through and read the confusion matrix in detail. So second example is ranking according to entropy and also the classification based on some entropy. So this is only the example. If the value, larger value is there, there must be an entropy of the larger value of entropy and gain. Then again it gives the better attribute. Okay. So in this topic we conclude filter approach is very fast because it does not go with algorithm, it based on the data and fix on some of the attributes from the data. But when the number of attributes is very large, so don't go for the algorithm. Better wrapper algorithm having the extensive computation, but better result can be achieved. Computation is very extensive, but the result is achieved. Okay, so this is all about the today's lecture based on subject selection. I hope you all understood. Thank you.